Hi, this is JD and I'm here with Joyce Talk. Over the years, Indians have slowly but steadily climbed up the corporate ladders globally and have also played a key role in the development of many of the technology powerhouses all over the world. Making India proud are Indian origin CEOs, to name a few: Satya Nadella of Microsoft, Sundar Pichai of Alphabet, Shantanu Narayan of Adobe, Arvind Krishna of IBM, Parag Agrawal of Twitter, Ivan Menges of Diageo, Puneet Ranjan of Deloitte, Sonia Singhal of Gap, Basan Narsimhan of Novartis, Lakshman Narsimhan of Reckitt, Ben Kaiser, Sandeep Mathrani of WeWork, Revati Advaiti of Flex, Anjali Sood of Vimeo, Jayasri Ullal of Arista Networks, George Kurian of NetApp, Sandeep Kataria of Beta Brands, and a host of others. Today, I will talk about Leena Nair, the latest addition to this rich list of Indian origin corporate leaders. So, who is Leena Nair? Nair, 52, started her career as a management trainee at Unilever in 1992. Leena has been a pioneer throughout her career at Unilever, but more so than in her role as CHRO, where she has been a driving force on our equity, diversity, and inclusion agenda, on the transformation of our leadership development, and on our preparedness for the future of work, Unilever CEO Alan Jope said while announcing her exit. British national Nair, who featured in India Fortune magazine's 2021 list of most powerful women, is widely praised for her people-focused approach to business. When you look after your people, they will look after the business, she told the magazine. French luxury group Chanel has named Nair as its global CEO. The 111-year-old French brand is known to be a close-knit family-controlled fashion house. A Chanel statement said, Alain Wethermeer, the owner, will move to the role of global executive chairman, and Nair will assume the role of global CEO based in London, UK. This makes Nair the second Indian origin woman to take over as a global CEO after Indra Nui. Incidentally, Nui happens to be Nair's mentor. The new partnership will further ensure long-term success as a private company, believing in the freedom of creation, cultivating human potential, and acting to have a positive impact in the world, it added. The $10 billion Chanel competes with global luxury firms like $50 billion LVMH or Louis Vuitton, Hermes, Gucci, L'Oreal, Michael Kors, among others. Nair said, I always tell HR people they need to walk with swagger. HR is no longer a backroom department, it's a vital part of running any successful business. If you want to support your people, you need to understand how the business works and you need to be visible within the business. Commenting on her appointment, Keki Dadishet, who was the chairman of Hindustan Unilever when Nair was a rising star, told TOI, she was always very competent and very ambitious and most importantly did better with increased responsibility. She richly deserved her success. Nair, who studied at Holy Cross Convent School in Kolhapur and passed out as an engineer in electronics and telecommunication from Walchand College of Engineering-Sangli, opted to pursue HR much to the dismay of her father, an industrialist from Kolhapur. That was a major turning point for Nair, who decided to follow her heart after joining HUL as a management trainee in 1992. Nair worked in various roles in factories, sales, and the corporate headquarters in HUL. She brought about several changes and rose through the ranks to become Executive Director HR in 2016. She went to become the first woman as well as Asian and the youngest ever CHRO of Unilever and member of the Unilever Leadership Executive with responsibility for the company's 150,000 people across more than 100 countries globally. Nair is breaking several stereotypes, not just with respect to gender, but leadership traits as well. While the world has mostly seen and preferred the command and control kind of leadership, Nair, on the other hand, is vocal about traits such as humility and empathy. Recently, she even said how leaders would not become weak if they revealed their vulnerable side or by admitting to making mistakes. Nair is also a non-executive member of British Telecom PLC, a member of the board of the Leverhulme Trust, and was a non-executive director in the UK's Department of Business, Energy and Industrial Strategy. Nair is married with two sons, and her interests include reading, running, and Bollywood dancing. That is all for today. Do subscribe, share, and be with me for my forthcoming bi-weekly videos. I will keep coming with knowledge-based, interesting videos. Please do not forget to put in your valuable thoughts and comments. Thank you. Goodbye for now. See you in the next video.